Messiah come, Christ has risen. He truly has risen. Welcome you all in the name of the Lord. We are privileged to use the Maronite ritual of the Catholic faith, giving praise and rejoicing in the resurrection of our Lord. You have several options. You can follow along in the booklet, the big book, or on the screen over to your right. During the liturgy, we'll use English and some Syriac and some Arabic. Lord, we be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Lord Jesus, make us worthy of the abundance of your grace and mercy to glorify your resurrection with pure hearts, to celebrate your victory with holy hymns, and to proclaim your might with pure tongues. We thank you for your love and worship you, crying out, Christ is risen, he is truly risen. To you be glory, to your Father, and to your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
To the good one be glory and honor on this feast, and all the days of our lives and forever.
Amen.
We worship and praise you, only begotten Son. You descended into the darkness of the tomb and worked wonders in the realm of the dead. By your resurrection, you freed the captives. And by your voice, you awakened the righteous and the just who had gone to their rest in the sleep of death. You gathered the nations to worship you and to proclaim your salvation. They rejoice and cry out. On Friday, the king endured pain and was crucified. And today, victory has been achieved by his resurrection. On Friday, a lance pierced his side, and today, in his compassion, the waters of baptism flow. On Friday, he was crowned with thorns, and today, he was adorned his church with a crown of splendor. Today is a day of rejoicing in the resurrection. Today is a day of rejoicing for all who have gone to the rest in the hope of the resurrection. Today, with the fragrance of this incense, the church and her children celebrate and sing hymns of glory. O Creator of life, you have saved us by your passion, and have given us life by your resurrection. Now renew our image by your grace. Clothe our bodies with the power of the Spirit, so that we may shine in the robe of glory, and in his light see you, the true bridegroom. In your grace, make us and all the faithful departed worthy of your heavenly kingdom. that we may raise glory and thanks to you, to your Father and your Holy Spirit forever.
Brothers and sisters, if Christ is proclaimed as raised from the dead, how can some of you say there is no resurrection of the dead? If there is no resurrection of the dead, and Christ has not been raised, and if Christ has not been raised, then our proclamation has been in vain, and your faith has been in vain. We are even found to be misrepresenting God, because we testify of God that he raised Christ, whom he did not raise, if it is true that the dead are not raised. For if the dead are not raised, then Christ has not been raised. If Christ has not been raised, your faith is futile, and you are still in your sins. Then those who have died in Christ have perished. If for this life only we have hoped in Christ, we are of all people most to be pitied. But in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have died. For since death came through a human being, the resurrection of the dead has also come through a human being. For as all die in Adam, so all be made alive in Christ, but each in his own order. Christ, the first fruits. Then, at his coming, those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end, when he hands over the kingdom of God to the Father, after he has destroyed every ruler and every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death.
Praise be to God always.
So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciples, whom Jesus loved, and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciples went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciples ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciples also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned home, but Mary stayed outside the tomb weeping. And so she wept. She bent over into the tomb and saw two angels in white sitting there, one at the head and one at the feet where the body of Jesus had been. And they said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken my Lord, and I don't know where they laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus there, but did not know it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" She thought it was the gardener and said to him, "Sir, if you carry him away, tell me where you laid him, and I'll take him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabuni," which means teacher. She said to her, "Stop holding on to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and tell them, I am going to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary of Magdala went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord." This is the truth. Peace be with you.
Experiences, the loss of loved ones,
But there is a lot of crying going on in this particular gospel. During Holy Week, I focused on mostly Jesus' willingness to put up with being heard. That we cannot get through life without getting heard. You know, with little babies and children, you kiss them and make them feel better. A little older left, they want all kinds of band-aids put all over them. We have all kinds of ways to deal with our pain. And crying is certainly one that's universal everywhere in any place one would go. There's no doubt how much Mary loved Jesus. And her tears weren't because she didn't have faith. There were tears because she was bewildered. And very often when we get hurt or we lose somebody, our emotions and our feelings don't always stay under our control. There was interesting in the newspaper, they were writing about how funerals have changed. And a former Baptist minister said that when he first started his ministry, his purpose was to try to comfort them so they wouldn't cry. That if you were able to stop people from crying, that meant you were doing a good job. And I was wondering whether or not that minister had ever talked to my dad. He was German, and he didn't believe in crying. But he had a stroke. And one day he said to me, he said, "Larry, how come I'm crying all the time?" And I said, "Can I give you two answers? You can pick the one you like the most." "I am a son now." He said, "Okay. One, you're German and you never cried and now you have to catch up." I said, "Dad, you had a stroke. You know you can't hold on to and control your fears and your hurts and your pains as well as you could before. And so it makes perfect sense that you find yourself crying more often." And I said, in the Syriac tradition, those are the way we get cleansed, the way we get purified, the way we move forward. But there is nothing wrong with it. It's not a lack of faith. It's not being too soft. It's not being not strong enough. It means that you belong to the human race. Jesus chose to belong to the human race. And I have seen a TV show about the Passion. I never saw it before, but in this story, they had this man always behind Jesus playing the role of the devil, always giving him reasons why he should change his mind, always whispering in his ear, "You know you're going to get hurt. You know they're going to betray you. You know that hardly anybody's going to say thank you. They're not going to appreciate it. You spend all this time with them and they're still not going to understand what's going on. They don't really understand what you're saying. Why are you bothering going through with this and being humiliated and it's not even going to work?" I reflected on that a little more deeply because how often do we run across someone, and sometimes it's ourselves, that we are unwilling to do certain things for the Lord because we don't want to get hurt? You know, you are always bumping into people that back when they were in fourth grade, somebody said something to them when they were young and it scared them and frightened them and they don't want to go to church anymore. Or someone forgot to say thank you, or said the wrong thing, a little short, got hurt, and don't want to do it anymore. Well, that isn't what Jesus has called us to do. Jesus, by his own example in our human flesh, even while he was being mocked, nailed on a cross, still continued to pray for humanity. Forgive them, Father. They don't know what they're doing. And I could just picture the, you know, the little devil sitting there and says, oh yeah, they know what they're doing. Come off the cross, beat them up. Show them who's going to be the king from now on, and they're going to pay for everything they've done. Well, that's not the message of Jesus Christ. The message of Jesus Christ is, I know that humans are a bunch of idiots. You know, you don't have to quote that anywhere. Amnesia. But you know what I mean. I mean, parents say it to their children, maybe. We say it to each other, we say it to ourselves. How come we make these terrible mistakes? We promise we're never going to do anything wrong again, and we do it. But life is filled with tears and hurt, and there's no escaping. And then we have to decide whether we take the voice and the example of Jesus Christ, or the one that's whispering behind the back that's making a list of every time we got hurt. And it's hard not to look at that list. I look at my list. Maybe I should write in a different language so I can't read it, but it's deep within our heart. But then, what are we going to do with all of this hurt and this pain and these tears? And that brings us to this moment, to this day. We're going to die in them so we can be raised in them. Before liturgy, the pre-liturgy, when they were singing the hymn and the song is the Alleluia, and it just became so obvious to me that God has the power. That no matter what has happened to us, if we let him be the one who leads us out of our fears and our tears and our hurts, that Alleluia will sink all the way as deep into our heart as it needs to go. That even if we can't quite grasp it right now, quite understand it now, and we were never meant to understand death and tears. It's not logical. God didn't make it as part of his plan. We made it part of our plan by our decisions. But my prayer is that during this service, somewhere, someplace, during the day, that you will hear this quiet voice enter to the deepest part of your heart and hear him say your name. Because he says each one of our names is the most deepest love. That he decided to go through with it. He gathered up all of my hurts and all of your hurts, all of my tears, all of your tears, and he went into the tomb. And as the Maronite prayers say so beautifully, you know, I joke, and I hope it's not sacrilegious, but, you know, if he would have stayed in there a whole week, I would have had a week off. But he wasn't just laying there. It says those prayers where he went down unto the dead. Now, imagine all of your loved ones who have passed on in death. That he was going to go visit all of them. But after the resurrection, he greets all of them. And so there goes my plans, you know, get to work. Keep going. Be strong. You know me well enough that I have my weaknesses. says, and I don't pretend to be better than anyone else. We're all in it together. When either one of us fall, we're going to help each other up. Even if it's just the smile or the greeting. But we're not going to give up. We're going to keep going. We have a healer. We have a consoler. We have a compassionate Lord who has the power to shut down all the wrong voices and say the right prayers for us before the Heavenly Father. And we will hear the most tenderest word, the most tenderest love, the most compassionate phrase. Today it was Mary. But deep in your heart, say the name of the people that you love the most, that you've had tears over. Say their name deep down in your heart. And then multiply it by infinity with Jesus saying the same name with so much courage and so much love. I hate to do this, but we're going to take up a collection now. No, I really don't need that. I'm kind of glad, but.
Jesus Christ, our Lord, the Son of God, you are Lord, Jesus Christ. You saved us from the slavery of Satan. Grant peace and security to the children of your church. We call out to you in prayer. O Lord, hear us.
Thank you.
Christ truly has risen.
Your presence as they bow their bodies and souls before you.
to continuously glorify you, your Father, and your Holy Spirit, now and forever. You saved us from going astray by your life-giving cross, and have given us a way to heaven. By your cross, worshipers are kept safe night and day and are protected from the evil one in his power. By your cross, sustain the elderly, subdue the haste of youth, educate the young, and nurture children. By your cross, sanctify priests and purify deacons. By your cross, heal the sick and the suffering. By your cross, establish your church and strength and make your monasteries and convents firm. By your cross, may all people live in peace and harmony. By your cross, guard us from all distress and lead us to perfection. By your cross, grant eternal rest to the faithful departed. In purity and holiness, we celebrate the feast of the resurrection, and at your second coming, make us worthy to meet you in joy. We raise glory and thanks to you, now and forever.
Amen.
The creed can be found on the screen or on page 748. We believe
in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all the ages, God of God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the power of the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and we look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Thank you.
offerings of our ancestors. Now accept these offerings that your children brought to you out of their love for you in your holy name. Shower your spiritual blessings upon them, and place them there as a gift. Grant them life in your kingdom.
Amen.
As we remember our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, and his plan of salvation for us, we call upon this offering all those who please God from Adam to this day. Especially Mary, the Blessed Mother of God, St. Mary, St. Joseph, and St. Jude. Remember, O God, the children of the Holy Church, our fathers and mothers, and our brothers and sisters, both the living and the departed, especially those of St. Joseph's Maronite Church. Remember also all those who share with us today in this offering.
Amen.
Spirit be with you. Let the angels re-glorify you with voice of praise to pray out and proclaim holy.
Thank you for them, and because of them,
we pray.
bread, assist the priests, the deacons, and all those who serve your holy church, so that they may intercede and pray to you on our behalf. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, your people here before you, especially those who presented these offerings. Forgive them so that they may always live blameless lives in your presence and recognize the blessings that you bestow upon them. For your good and rich in graces, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, the civil leaders throughout the world, that they may stand for justice and establish peace. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember all those who struggle with chronic illness, anxiety, and pain in their lives, that they will find healing and comfort in the Lord. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and a consecrated life to serve the Maronite Church. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, all those who have pleased you from the beginning, especially Mary, the Holy Mother of God, prophets, apostles, martyrs, and confessors, John the Baptist, Stephen the Archdeacon, St. Joseph, St. Maron, St. Jude. Assist us through their prayers and make us worthy to replace them in your kingdom. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, the fathers and teachers of the true faith who have endured sufferings for the sake of your church and of your people. We truly and faithfully follow in your footsteps. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for the Christians throughout the world that are being persecuted, that God keep them safe, give them courage and strength, and a change of heart and conversion for those who are motivated by hate. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Favorably remember, O Lord, our parents, brothers and sisters, teachers, and all the faithful departed here and everywhere who have gone to the rest, especially members of St. Joseph. Forgive us and forgive them of all sins and offenses. Through our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ, who is without sin, we hope to find mercy and forgiveness for our sins and for theirs.
Grant rest, O God, to the departed, and forgive the sins we have committed, with and without full knowledge.
Grant us pardon, O God, and forgive us in the departed, so that your blessed name may be glorified in us and in all things. With the name of our Lord Jesus Christ and your living Holy Spirit, now and forever.
As it was, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Lead us not into the trials and temptation that we do not have the strength to overcome. But deliver us from every evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, for the only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us bow our heads before the God of mercy, before his forgiving altar, and before the body and blood of our Savior who gives life to those who partake of him, and receive the blessing from the Lord.
O Lord, bless your worshipers who bow before you and implore you. Make them worthy of your mercy and forgive their sins. For your almighty and rich in compassion, we raise glory and thanks to you and to your only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
The grace of the Most Holy Trinity, eternal and consubstantial be with you, my brothers and sisters, forever.
And with your spirit.
Let each one of us look to God with reverence and humility and ask him for mercy and compassion.
Holy gifts for the holy, with perfection, purity, and sanctity.
One Holy Father, one Holy Son, one Holy Spirit, blessed be the name of the Lord, for he is one in heaven and on earth, to him be glory forever. Make us worthy, O Lord God, so that our bodies may be sanctified by your holy body, and our souls purified by your forgiving blood. May our community be for the forgiveness of our sins and for new life. O Lord our God, to you be glory forever.
Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, for sins and eternal life. body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Church, we're going to run out and go to the Dunkin' Donuts. Thank you so much for being so supportive and entering into the spirit of Lent and celebrating a beautiful, beautiful Easter, and the choir for all the time that they put in the practices.
May the offering I have.